guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Sibonile Mpele and we are back again with another video. Today we are doing a vlog, guys. As I've mentioned that I was not posting any content due to limitations explained in the previous video, but I've been taking content all this time, so I'm trying to make space on my camera and ensuring that I upload those videos so that I can make new content. So please allow me to upload this vlog. Let us enjoy it and ensure that you like and you subscribe to the channel. But mostly I want to thank all of you for being here, for loving the content, for subscribing into the channel, and for those that have not yet subscribed, please do so. You're helping me to grow into YouTube, and also by liking, you're simply telling YouTube that this is a good video and it can play on YouTube because there are no bad things that are happening in that video. So this vlog is simply about me going out with the kids. So please do like, please do comment on the video. And yes, these are my besties that likes to come and join us. Okay, let's go to the vlog.
Say what you wanna say to me now. I wanna wake up with you in the morning. Show me this other fake to me now.
So guys, we have arrived into the place where we're going with the kids. Just a little background, why this place? Why did we choose this kind of a setup? I know that with so many parents, you choose it because your kids are able to play in it. But we chose this place because it's convenient for our son. This is my son. He's autistic. Yes, he is autistic. I did not know about autism until my son was diagnosed with autism. So every time we're going out, more especially when he is also going, because we don't take him everywhere anytime, we also need to also allow the sisters to do the things that they are able to do while he is at home. So we chose this place because he loves to bounce, he loves running around, he loves shushuluzing, the way that you see. He loves like high places, he loves heights, he loves water, he loves all these things that I think they are dangerous. That's him. Then now we are starting to understand the person that he is.
Well done. Well done.
And how we can assist him in ensuring that he sees normal things, he's exposed to normal things without us worrying about the environment where he's currently into. So that is why we chose this kind of places. We are proud of him. He's making so much progress, but also it's within us, family, relatives and friends, to understand what we need to do for him to make him feel comfortable. Because in spaces where it's confined spaces, for example, we can't take him to Nando's. He will not be able to enjoy being there, because that setup wants you to sit down and then you eat. But places like McDonald's, because there are things to play, he'll be playing there, doing his own thing, minding his own businesses while we are enjoying food. So that's why we chose this place. So this place is in Brooklyn, in Pretoria East. It's 80 rands per child. The last time I was there, it was 80 rands per child. And they play for 1 hour. Then if you still want them to play more, you pay again. But the only thing that I like about this is that they allow you to go in, you go play, and they give you a tag or a number where everything that you do is going to be billed in that number. So, for example, we had three kids, and
they were allowed to play. If they need anything to eat, they just go to the other side, buy something, then they can play. Once we are done with everything, that's when and when we're going to pay the bill. It's more likely like your restaurant, you do whatever that you do, you enjoy, then you pay later.
Amen.
Yes, it was time for eating, and to tell you, we did not go outside. See, my son, he doesn't enter. Where now you need to sit him down. Now we are eating. No, that's not him. That's why you see daddy and him minding their own business there. So here I'm just showing you that you can get anything, mommy and daddy. You can take your kids while you go there to get your hot drinks, your cold drinks, milkshake, they are there, beers and gin, wine, it is there. So you're allowed to drink while you're watching your kids playing. So it's basically that. Then you get someone to drive you home so that you arrive alive. So we were going back home here. It was still during the day because the kids only played 2 rounds. Then they ate, they went back to play, then we headed home. I had few things to do before the sun set, like cooking and all those. I'm a mom to 5 kids. I have 2 older daughters. One is teenager, one is an adult now. Then I have these 3 that I need to serve individually. So I'm a wife, I'm a young wife. So all of those roles, they need me to play them fully, be there, be present. So I try by all means to be in spaces where I need to be at all times. So this is me cooking uphuthu, because ngaba yini ngaphandle kuphuthu, ngaba yini Nkosi yami. So it's basically nje ukudla kwasekhaya, that's what I can say. But uphuthu, I was cooking uphuthu just to make amasi for the whole family. One thing that you'll find in my fridge always, Monday to Friday, then we cook again with amasi, because we love amasi like that, so we don't run out of amasi. And then I was cooking a supper for the whole family. This side, if you don't find me dancing or singing out loud at my place, I know that I'm just worried about my tummy. That's all. I'm just worried about umkhaba wami, ukuthi how can I swallow it without feeling pain. But besides that, we are just happy people. I'm just saying, guys. But on a serious note, I also baked. I love baking. It's one of my other things that I love doing. But I don't want to invest so much in it, because it would I'll lose the love that I have for flour, more especially eating it. So I just do when I'm able to. Here it's just bread. I know it looks amazing. It's not a cake, it's just bread. I just, you know? So it's basically that. Then I did, I dished up food. This is how I dished up. I don't know why. I saw it on TikTok and I thought it was a cool thing to do. So this is how I dish up for him. Then it was time for me to put the kids to bed. And I really appreciate the time and the love we're getting from friends and family members in ensuring that they are with us in this situation. We've never had anyone around us with autism. We did not know what autism is. It's something that we've been learning and still continue to do. So if you see a mom going through something, or they even not showing that their kids are autistic, but you can see their signs, social behavior and all of that, do not judge. do not judge people until you walk a mile in their shoes. Beside that, care, be kind. Ask, how can I assist? Because it's a lot for them also. Sometimes we even feel sad that, yo, these people, they think that we're doing this intentionally. But no. In all of that, I thank you for watching this video. Please do like, do subscribe, and please do comment, how did you find this video? Thank you so much. Liking and commenting and subscribing is completely free, friends. You can just friend me on YouTube and assist me to grow my channel. Really love being here. Thank you so much for watching. Mwah. Bye.